The reality check of the oxygen related deaths that took place in April, May. Is the government therefore guilty of misleading parliament? Is the Modi government living in denial? Are the centre and the states trying to hide their failures during COVID 2.0? Are governments both at the centre and state denying COVID victims dignity in death? These are some of the questions I want to pose tonight. I'm joined by Dr. S.C.L. Gupta, Medical Director, Batra Hospital. Remember, this was one of the hospitals that complained of oxygen shortage. China NC, BJP spokesperson, Raghav Chadda, Aam Aadmi Party spokesperson and MLA, Supriya Srinath, Congress spokesperson. Let's come to you first, doctor, before I come to the politicians and where they stand. I want to know from you, when you hear in parliament, the minister stand up and say, our data indicates there were no oxygen-related deaths. What will you say? Yes, Dr. Batra.
Hello.
Okay.
I'm Dr. Gupta.
Yes, Dr. Gupta. Sorry. Dr. Gupta of Batra Hospital. Go ahead, sir.
I was shocked because those 45 days, वो 45-50 दिन भूल नहीं सकते हैं हम लोगों को. किस तरह से ऑक्सीजन के बगैर, कम ऑक्सीजन के साथ सुबह से शाम तक एक तलवार सर पे लटकती थी. दिल्ली सरकार ने हमें 500 बेड के अस्पताल को 400 बेड कोविड किए थे. 400 बेड कोविड में प्रैक्टिकली एवरी डे डिमांडिंग फॉर ऑक्सीजन,
राइट?
और हमें ऑक्सीजन हम खपत कर रहे थे, हमें नहीं मिल रही थी. और रोज
सो इज द मिनिस्टर सो डॉक्टर गुप्ता नहीं नहीं तो अगर पार्लियामेंट इफ द मिनिस्टर इन पार्लियामेंट सेज देयर वर नो ऑक्सीजन रिलेटेड डेथ्स, इज द मिनिस्टर रिसोर्टिंग टू मियर टेक्निकलिटी? बिकॉज ऑन द डेथ सर्टिफिकेट यू राइट दिस इज अ कार्डियो रेस्पिरेटरी फेलियर एंड देयरफॉर द मिनिस्टर इज रिसोर्टिंग टू अ टेक्निकलिटी, इज दैट ट्रू डॉक्टर गुप्ता?
देखिए यहाँ पर दो बातें हैं. नंबर वन, मिनिस्टर ने जो भी जवाब दिया दैट डिपेंड्स ऑन, बिकॉज दिस इज अ स्टेचुअरी बॉडी. पार्लियामेंट में जो भी रिटन क्वेश्चन आते हैं उस क्वेश्चन का जो जवाब दिया जाता है उस जवाब की ऑथेंटिसिटी होती है. ऑथेंटिसिटी ये है कि केंद्र सरकार को राज्य सरकारें बताती हैं और यूनियन टेरिटरीज बताती हैं कि उनके उस क्षेत्र में कितनी डेथ्स हुई हैं और कैसे हुई हैं.
What is your belief? If you were in the minister's place, would you have said that there were deaths because of oxygen shortage or not? Yes or no?
See, this is a million-dollar question. I would have replied in the way that state governments, since they have not supplied the information to the Kendra, central government information was lacking from state governments. And the state government's health is a state subject. And since they could not get the information from the state that there was no deaths because of oxygen scarcity, so what we have to say is, as a minister, he will definitely say that, yes, of course, there was no deaths.
Okay, but so you're saying the state government... I'll come back to you, Dr. Gupta. You're saying that the state government should have given the exact information to the center. Now, Supriya Srinath, respond. Here is Dr. Gupta, whose Batra hospital was struggling for oxygen, saying, look, yes, there was a shortage of oxygen. Yes, that's one of the reasons why people died in hospitals like Batra. But why did the center not reply? Why don't you start, Supriya Srinath, and then I'll go to Raghav Chadda.
Fair point. I will begin by first saying that I think this is adding salt to the injuries of people who lost their lives, to families, to children who have been orphaned, to parents who've lost young children. Having said that, why is it that the states could not talk about oxygen paucity and deaths related to that? The answer lies in the ICMR guideline, page number 6, the guidelines for the appropriate recording of COVID-19 related death. And this has been pointed out by the Organized Medicine Academic Guild, a federation of about 15 professional associations of PG doctors in India. And they categorically state, and I'm quoting from there, that asphyxia, respiratory arrest, respiratory failure cannot be mentioned as a cause of death. So the central government guidelines itself is prohibiting states to mention oxygen of shortage as a cause of death. Now, having said that, if that technicality is the reason why the government is saying there mm-hmm. were no COVID-related deaths, it should have got up in Parliament and said, we have issued guidelines. Mm-hmm. These deaths cannot be related as COVID-related deaths, but deaths have happened. You have blatantly and brazenly told the upper house of Parliament and the people of this country that not a single person died due to the lack of oxygen. What are you going to tell people who were giving artificial oxygen to their wives, to their parents, to their children, so that they could survive? We saw how bad the situation was. This mm-hmm. government has no data on deaths due to demonetization. It has no data due to deaths of migrant laborers. It has no data on the death of oxygen shortage. What does it have data on snooping? Because that's what it was busy doing. The reality is that you have prohibited the states to record asphyxiation and respiratory failure deaths due to your guidelines. Okay, and they continue to be enforced. They continue to be enforced, these ICMR guidelines, just to point out.
Yes, okay. You've made the point. And I know, therefore, a number of doctors are telling me that in those reports, it's reported as cardiorespiratory failure. It is not necessarily reported as a death due to shortage of oxygen. Raghav Chadda, however, in an affidavit that the Aam Aadmi Party, which today is screaming blue murder over what the government center said, the Kejriwal government filed an affidavit in the court based on the inputs of a four-member committee constituted by the Delhi government, which claimed there were no deaths in Delhi because of oxygen shortage. This is the charge against AAP. Today, you are blaming the center.
No. Mr. Sardesai, if you were to read through the entire High Court order of that very day, of the proceedings that took place on that very day, you would find in para 10 that the government of Delhi has also said that we are going to constitute a six-member committee to investigate all such deaths, because whenever somebody dies, hospitals usually put either cardiac arrest or mm-hmm. respiratory or pulmonary or respiratory failure as the principal cause of death. So therefore, it is important that six educated doctors go through these steps and the causes that led to the cardiac arrest, etc., to arrive at a conclusion whether mm-hmm. the death happened due to lack of oxygen or not. And subsequently, we also submitted that this committee will then come out with a report as to how many people died because of lack of oxygen, and we will also award 5 lakh rupees as compensation to each family.
Why did you not inform the health ministry, yeah. Mr. Chadda, very clearly that people had died of oxygen shortage? You've given the government a way to get away. You've given them a free pass.
I was about to answer this very question, Mr. Sardesai. The government of India, the central government, the BJP-led government, through the Lieutenant Governor's office, stalled the very constitution and therefore the functioning of this committee and did not let this committee function. Perhaps the reason was to conceal their own mismanagement of liquid medical oxygen's equitable distribution. That committee was stalled. Now, you can ask us, Qua Delhi, I've responded to it. My question is that 2/3 of India is run, as far as state government is concerned, run by the BJP. What about BJP-led state governments like Bihar, UP, Madhya Pradesh, where we saw people gasping for breath outside hospitals on the streets and dying? Forget that. AIIMS and Safdarjung, which are situated in Delhi, we saw all those horrific scenes on your shows also, on your channel also. Why did AIIMS and Safdarjung Hospital, which are headed by the Union Health Minister himself, not report these figures to the Union Health Ministry? And therefore, it actually boils down to the fact that this is a shameless and a heartless government run by ruthless leaders. Today, they are saying that there was no lack of oxygen. Tomorrow, they will say, Mr. Sardesai, mark my words, that there was no shortage of beds. Then they will say there is no shortage of vaccine. They will go on to say that there was no black marketing of remdesivir. And perhaps we will be given to understand that there is nothing called as COVID. It is an international conspiracy to defame India.
Okay,
and as somebody who has been a witness to this entire mayhem that took place in the capital, as somebody who was manning the SOS phone calls, I can tell you that this is the greatest harm and trauma that one can cause to those who have lost their lives, the families of those who have lost their lives.
Your affidavit, though, could have been stronger in court, Mr. Chadda. The truth is, your affidavit could have been stronger in court. But no, one minute.
Does an individual affidavit represent the position of the entire government?
Okay.
Go through that order of that very day.
Okay.
On one issue, qua one hospital, on one day, we filed an affidavit. But in that very order of that proceedings, on para number 10, we say we wish to go ahead and constitute a committee
understand
the cause of death.
You made your point. The real question, though, has to be to Shaina NC and the BJP, because the BJP government, your minister, Mrs. Pawar, stands up in Parliament and says, we have no data on reported deaths. Last year, you had no data on migration. and on those who are migrating. You have no data when you are asked on unemployment, how many people have lost their jobs during COVID-19. I mean, this is a government which tells us data on other issues, but not on the data that matters, China NC. I mean, surely there could have been more sensitivity shown in the response, albeit a written reply which follows a certain procedure. But surely the government could have been a little bit more empathetic. How can you say no data?
So, Rajdeep, what did the Minister of State, Praveen Pawar, say today? She said that during the second COVID wave,
yes,
wanted the states to undertake a series of actions, including providing medical oxygen and other clinical care of COVID-19, and patients were in view of steep COVID rise in terms of the trajectory across the country from April to May 21st. But she also specified hospitals is determined.
We are having a problem, sadly, with your audio, Shaina NC. Okay, we're going to try and get back your audio. Can you hear?
Can I continue?
Yes, go ahead. Your audio. There was a problem with your audio. Tell us, what are you trying to say? What is the reasoning that the government can give beyond blaming the states?
The unprecedented surge in demand of medical oxygen during the second wave, the demand in the country peaked to nearly 9,000 metric tons as opposed to 3,095 metric tons during the first wave. Now, the central government stepped in to facilitate equitable distribution to the state.
Not at all. No.
Shaina NC, a simple question, a straight question is posed to your minister. Why can't the minister accept that there was an oxygen shortage? Why is it that you are now on a serious issue like this, you pass the buck onto the states? Surely the government could have accepted, yes, as you said, there was a serious demand for oxygen in those days, which led to a shortage.
I don't know if you could hear what I said.
Yes, go ahead.
Were you able to hear what
I said
this equipment, such as oxygen cylinders, concentrators, pressure swing, oxygen generation plants, etc. We know that the requirement from which used to be 3,095 metric tons was stepped up to 9,000 metric tons. Now, if the central government has stepped in to facilitate equitable distribution to the states have to also reply when it comes to death, whether it's comorbidities, whether somebody has lost life because of diabetes or heart or respiration problems, etc. And this is the information which is collated. So she has not lied.
So she's a post. She's a post office. You're telling me. You are telling me, China NC. Just a minute, ma'am. Ma'am, you are telling me that the health minister of this country is acting like a post office. He takes information and simply puts it before parliament without making any attempt, whether it's with migrants a year ago, whether it's with jobs in September last year or today, whether it is with oxygen deaths. Is that all that the center is doing? Being a post office.
1 second. Rajdeep, you're a serious journalist.
Yes, I am.
Do you know what the Maharashtra state government has told the Mumbai High Court? That no patient has died of oxygen shortage in Maharashtra.
Supriya Shinde, do not intervene, please.
Deputy CM Manish Sisodia accused the central government of so-called lying in parliament. And attached are the excerpts from the official report of the Delhi government, where they themselves submitted to the High Court stating that no COVID deaths in Delhi took place due to lack of oxygen. Now you tell me, if you have likewise similar reports coming from Chhattisgarh, when Bharati Pawarji was speaking in parliament, what did she say? She said this is the collated reports coming from each state. Yes, there was a shortage of oxygen. Yes, we did step in and we did supply to the best of our ability. But if there has been deaths because of comorbidities, the states have reported so, and this is the finding.
Okay. So you're saying that the BJP has gone by, the minister has gone by what the states have said. So it's boiling down to how states and the center are looking at the definition of a death due to oxygen shortage.
And
I'll give you China NC 1 minute. I'll give you the example of Goa. your minister on record, and let's play those bites for a moment. I'm going to play a series of bites of ministers of the BJP government from Goa to different places who said the deaths were due to oxygen. Producer, can we play those bites? Please play Mr. Gadkari first.
मुझे बहुत दुखद रूप से ये देखने का मौका मिला कि ऑक्सीजन न होने के कारण हॉस्पिटल के कंपाउंड वॉल के बाहर लोगों की मृत्यु देखने के लिए मिली.
So I guess Mr. Gadkari, when he says that he felt bad that people died because of oxygen shortage, how do you respond to that, China NC? I can try many more. Vishwajit Rane, Health Minister of Goa.
To examine, a four-member committee was mandated to examine the case sheets of all such patients to determine whether the cause of death was due to shortage of oxygen or otherwise. In addition, seeking data from all the hospitals and nursing homes on every such death. Now, this requirement comes to the central government, we know, from the states. And in response to a query given by a particular thing, it has been reviewed not just by the committee, but also by the independent hospitals that where they have gone back and forth. So if there is no mention of oxygen shortage in a particular case record, that is the reason why.
So Bharti we have Kavarji gone back to a classic yes minister like bureaucratic approach. Okay, you made your point. No. Supriya Srinath, now you respond. You've been itching to get in. Please respond, because there will be the question mark that every state government in a way is hiding behind the reality of what happened. Will your Chhattisgarh government, Rajasthan government of Congress say how many people died of oxygen shortage?
I will answer that question, but I'm actually appalled by the brazenness, first of the minister in the house and now of the BJP spokesperson hiding behind comorbidities. Is that your best excuse, that people died because of comorbidities? No, ma'am, people, I have lost people in my family due to the shortage of oxygen, and there are many more people who will cite example. There is not a single person in this country who will today say they do not know of someone impacted by COVID, impacted by oxygen shortage. I want to point out one important thing, because you know you were so quick to take credit. It is important to answer one question. India produces 7,500 metric tons of oxygen. Our peak requirement was only 8,900 metric ton. You know where we failed? We did not fail in producing oxygen. We failed in transporting oxygen from the producers to where it was required. Do you believe all these
Supriya
Srinath, all these people
why can
were
the,
in court
when,
for no reason?
Ma'am,
let me finish.
Ma'am, why you can't the health secretary or health minister of Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan say
can
this
I
in the written
in?
Reply to Ms. Pawar? What stops them
yes.
from saying it?
What
point.
Stops
I will answer that. I will answer that.
And Rajasthan
second.
Saying that? If there has been yeah. unprecedented surge in please demand
relax,
of medical oxygen during the second wave
please
and the demand
quiet,
in the country.
No,
China NC, please allow Supriya to speak. No, I've asked the question to Supriya Srinath, not to you. Please, China NC, okay. It's to Supriya Srinath. Please answer. What you're saying in the TV studio, why could the health minister or health secretary not say it in the written response to the health minister of the country?
I will answer that question, but I want to point out that the central government exported 700% more oxygen in 2020. It ignored the zero survey, it ignored the parliamentary standing committee's warning that there is going to be an oxygen shortage. Look at prices. You ignored everything in the book. You are responsible for oxygen shortage, and now you want to actually go and start blaming state governments. The reality, Rajdeep, is that Chhattisgarh is an oxygen producing state. They were exporting to other states like Uttar Pradesh. We saw how people in Uttar Pradesh were dying due to lack of oxygen. Are you now going to say that what the government says in parliament is garbage in and garbage out? The government has no business to verify what is happening.
Okay.
The government did not see the deaths that were happening. The government did not see people dying. I mean, how brazen, and if I may say, how insensitive this government has become. They have no data on people dying. They have no data on migrant labor. They have no data on unemployment. What do they have data
okay,
on?
Okay, you made that point earlier. Let's
that
listen in. Let's listen in to T.S. Singhdeo, the health minister of Chhattisgarh, what he said on this. Listen in.
जहाँ तक छत्तीसगढ़ का सवाल है, ये सही है कि ऑक्सीजन से रिपोर्टेड कमी के चलते रिपोर्टेड डेथ्स नहीं है. हम सरप्लस स्टेट रहे और प्रबंधन में कहीं ना कहीं लास्ट मिनट में कोई कहीं बैकअप कैसा था क्या नहीं था, दो चार मिनट का भी ऑफ हुआ हो, वरना ऑक्सीजन की कमी से डेथ छत्तीसगढ़ में रिकॉर्डेड नहीं है. ये तो सही है.
You know, what is troubling is that Rajdeep, we want an honest post-mortem from all of you.
Can I just say something?
No, 1 minute. Raghav Chadha, the honest post-mortem would have simply been this. Rather than Manish Sisodia today doing a press conference, if in your affidavit, I repeat, you all had been much stronger, if all the governments of this country accepted mea culpa, start accepting responsibility. You got it wrong. Whether it was at the state or center. No, Raghav Chadha. It is not just the Modi government. Every government failed us. That is the reality. Okay. And you should have the courage to say that in parliament. Like Manoj Jha had. No, 1 minute.
Oxygen.
No, I will play Manoj Jha's bite. Because Manoj Jha was the one person in parliament yesterday who had the courage to say, we all failed the country. Listening to Manoj Jha of the JDU. This is what we wanted to hear from all the political parties. Please listen in.
हम सबको एक साझा माफीनामा उन लोगों के नाम भेजना चाहिए जिनकी लाशें गंगा में तैर रही थी. किसी ने कह दिया ये, किसी ने कह दिया वो. ये पीड़ा व्यक्तिगत है, आंकड़ा मैं नहीं कहना चाहता हूँ. मेरा आंकड़ा, तुम्हारा आंकड़ा, अपनी पीड़ा में आंकड़ा ढूंढिए. एक व्यक्ति नहीं है इस देश में, इस सदन में, सदन के बाहर, उस सदन में, जो ये कहे कि उसने किसी जानने वाले को ना खोया हो. सर पीड़ा कह सकता हूं.
See, that is the passion that was missing in your debate, that is missing today. You come on TV studios, but you don't admit to the nation, we failed Indians. I want to ask you, Raghav, and then Mr. you, Supriya, as well, and Shaina, and see, 30 seconds to each of you. Are you willing to say, we got it wrong? You first, Raghav.
Mr. Sardesai, my leader and the Chief Minister of Delhi has time and again said that the entire establishment, whether it's the state government or the central government, has collectively failed those families who lost their loved ones. There is no doubt in that. I mean,
I'm glad you said that.
Acknowledging this.
I'm glad
not
you said
me,
that.
Not just me, my leader. Okay, my leader has
accepted
on so many occasions.
Okay,
but
can I? Shaina and see, just a minute. Raghav, you made the point.
Let me just finish my argument. Give me 15 more seconds, Mr.
Yeah,
Sardesai.
Go ahead. Okay.
But when I say that we have failed, we must also examine the reasons why we failed and who is in fact responsible for example, the supply of liquid medical oxygen. The High Court and the Supreme Court has fairly and squarely put the blame on the central government. Now, I don't wish to get into politics, but let me tell you that the reasons given by the BJP, whether it was Sambit Patra's press conference or the senior most people in the BJP making statements, is equivalent to the dog ate my homework argument. That merely because states did not, 2/3 of the states in this country are run by BJP-led administrations. Why couldn't they get data?
You've made your point, Mr. Chadha. Let me take that.
So how insensitive can a government get to come on the floor of the house and say, no death happened because of lack of oxygen? I think this is the highest amount of cruelty.
Okay, you made your point. Therefore, Shaina NC, at least the AAP spokesperson is admitting the establishment got it wrong.
No, I do too.
I don't know where. So why can't the Prime Minister or any senior leader come to Parliament and say, mea culpa, mujhe maaf karo, maafi nama, as Manoj Jha says, humne sabne, across party lines, is desh ko maafi nama dena hai. Apologize. Doesn't take much to say sorry.
Any COVID death requires an apology to not just the family, but I think to every Indian who has lost life.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at the dying deaths that have been issued by the Union Health Ministry to all states, the data was presented in Parliament yesterday. It was not
forget
collated
the data.
By the centre, but
forget
sent
the data
by
for
the
a
state.
Moment. Why can't you
no,
say
no,
sorry? We got it wrong.
Assess,
how long are you going to start? Continue to live in denial?
But it is a collective fail. If a life is lost. If a life is lost, it is the collective failure of everyone because we have lost Indians.
Sir, ma'am,
and that is
start,
the reason
the buck
why we need to unite
top.
In fighting.
Okay.
We kept on saying unite to fight COVID. And if the opposition says the centre has not put correct data, they should look and ask the state government what has gone wrong too.
Okay,
it is not
okay. Point taken.
Center,
your time is up. Supriya
Shine,
final word to you, ma'am. Will the Congress at least also do a, you know, it's very well for Rahul Gandhi to tweet all the time. Time that Rahul Gandhi also puts up his hand and says, Punjab, Rajasthan, governments ruled by the Congress have not done enough. Why can't you say that?
Rajdeep, I am here on your show saying we apologize for every COVID death in the country. But the buck on this stops with the central government. There is a National Disaster Management Act. The central government can't keep running away from responsibility. When there is a shortage of oxygen states, when there's a shortage of vaccination states, what is the central government expected to do? You floated a tender for 162 oxygen plants, 33, and very few are functional. You floated a tender for, I mean, you took 15 months to allow nitrogen cylinders to carry oxygen. What were you doing? You were too busy electioneering in Bengal. You did not do vaccines. You did not do oxygen. You were so busy snooping on people that you forgot your main responsibility to protect Indians. And the government of the day cannot shy away from this. I hate to say this. Everybody needs to put up their hands and apologize. But Mr. Modi cannot shy away and hide behind this excuse of states. That's not done.
Okay.
This is unpardonable.
Okay, I think every Indian citizen knows what happened in April, May. This is a time for, as I said, for all of us to accept, put our hands up and say things went wrong. And it is time that only when you admit your failures without putting the blame on others, when you are honest with data, that you can truly face the future. I hope that our political parties learn the value of empathy and sensitivity in the times in which we live. Thank you all very much for joining me there.